Oh, wow, that's loud. hello and welcome to, well, what we are talking about today. We're talking about something fun, something related to AWS CloudWatch. And we have Varsha and Dan today to talk to us about, well, about
real user monitoring for Amazon CloudWatch, right?
Exactly, yeah. before we get to the technology, I just want to say hello to the chat. Hello, chat on LinkedIn, Twitch, Twitter, wherever you're watching us from. Feel free to drop your questions in the chat there, right there, I guess. We would love to help and answer those things. And let's kick it off with introductions. Varsha, tell us who you are and what do you do and where do you join us from?
Hi, my name is Varsha Velagapudi, product manager with Amazon Web Services. I'm right now in Vegas for the reInvent event.
Everybody is. Everybody seems to be in
Vegas. Yeah, wonderful. Dan, tell us what you do.
Hi.
Hey.
Yeah. Let's see. I'm an engineer on CloudWatch RUM and CloudWatch Synthetics as well.
Thank you. Where do you join us from?
I am currently in a hotel room.
In a hotel room, also in Vegas, right?
Yes.
Okay, so
yeah, I'm so jealous. I'm
very, very jealous. Okay, so we talked about real user monitoring for Amazon CloudWatch. What is that? What are we launching?
Yeah, today we're launching Amazon CloudWatch RUM. Okay. So it's a new feature that we're adding. It's a real user monitoring capability. It gives you visibility into your application's client-side performance, and it allows you to enhance the end user experience.
Interesting. Awesome. And why is this?
Yeah,
why is something like...
Yeah. What problem does it solve? What challenge do customers have, and what does CloudWatch RUM help with?
Yeah, so customers, you know, often they need to understand how their end users are experiencing their applications.
Yeah.
And, you know, they have extensive infrastructure monitoring, but without this critical piece of information, they're missing the whole picture. So what CloudWatch RUM does is it allows them to collect client-side data on web application performance and identify and debug issues so they can reduce their mean time to resolution.
So issues like when there's a JavaScript error in the browser or when a name can't be resolved, things like that?
That's
right,
yes. Or when
there's latency, for instance?
Yeah, both of those actually. So it could be anything with latency. So, you know, page loads, any delays with any particular elements, or it could be errors. So this could be JavaScript errors, HTTP errors. And so you get visibility from across different geolocations, browsers, and devices, and it enables you to optimize the web application's performance.
Mm-hmm. So it is wonderful because like your infrastructure, your application actually extends to your client devices. It's not just like what's running in the cloud. It's also you need to have observability on the part of your user on the user. So I think it is very important that we have something like this. So how does this work? Tell us does it collect the data, collect logs and just performance metrics? What does it actually collect?
Yeah, so basically, you know, you can use CloudWatch RUM, and it's a lightweight JavaScript code snippet that you can add into your application's header, and once you add that, then you'll be able to collect all the client-side telemetry. And you know, CloudWatch RUM has rich visualization. We are able to provide you with dashboards that show you how your application is performing. This includes page load information. This includes errors, sessions, and it's streamlined for you to be able to identify any anomalies and spot them quickly and resolve them.
Awesome. Can you use this somehow with CloudWatch Synthetics? Does it work? How can you use CloudWatch Synthetics and CloudWatch RUM in this case?
So CloudWatch Synthetics, you know, customers use that today to be able to continuously monitor their endpoints and critical workflows. So CloudWatch right. Synthetics acts as a user, and it notifies customers if there's any issues. And so it's great for identifying issues, you know, even when there's no user traffic. Right. So you're alerted even before the customer is like, you know, has any issues or is impacted. However, you're missing some of the, you know, what is your actual end user experience? And CloudWatch RUM complements this data with this actual telemetry. And so CloudWatch RUM provides you with the last mile information. This could be anything like, you know, any issues with DNS resolution or connection time. And further, CloudWatch RUM allows you to quantify, like, if you see any issue, right? Like, for example, you know, if there's an error, like, you know, how many users are impacted because of that? And then, you know, you can prioritize based on that.
And there, I mean, there's a question here from Lebohang. Is there any dashboard to kind of what the activity has been done in the past hour? Like, I guess this all funnels the data into your CloudWatch, right? So you can just do with that information with what you will, right?
Yeah, so we within CloudWatch RUM, we have a rich visualization. I think we will see a little bit of that in the demo.
Okay.
And you also get some of the metrics, so you can alert with CloudWatch metrics, and you can add CloudWatch alarms to get alerted for any deviations.
Excellent. So, you know, speaking of the demo, you know, shall we bring up the demo? I think it's always wonderful, not just to us to talk about it, like the Brady Bunch here about the service, but I think we will be better off looking at the demo and just, well, commenting on it as well.
Yeah, so, a demo is worth 1,000 words.
Indeed.
Isn't that the saying?
Indeed. I think that's the old saying. Yeah. So, Dan, are you going to bring up the screen share?
Yeah.
Okay. While Dan is doing that, maybe Varsha, you can tell us, is there a difference between this service and AWS X-Ray coming from Sushovan?
Yeah, so basically what CloudWatch RUM does is it provides the client-side component. So okay. It's actually integrated with AWS X-Ray and with Service Lens, CloudWatch Service Lens. So you can now do end-to-end. So, you know, it's pretty powerful when you think about it. Like, you know, every user interaction, you'll be able to, like, trace it to how your resources responded and performed. So when there's any issue, you'll be able to quickly isolate, like, you know, the source of the issue and be able to respond to it.
Wonderful.
That's nice.
Okay, Dan, I'm bringing this up on screen right now.
Boom. All right.
So tell us what you're going to be showing us and show us. And pets. Wow.
Yes. Yeah. So yeah. So we want to run through basically how you can debug a customer impacting issue using CloudWatch RUM. But first, I wanted to show you my not-for-profit pet store adoption web app, and we'll actually see the client-side error that we're going to go debug. So here we have cute little pets waiting to be adopted. Let's take one home, and we just select one here. How about this one? So cute, as my daughter would say.
It is cute.
Hit pay, and I'm taken to adoption complete. That seemed to work out fine.
Okay.
I can go through, and I could do some searching.
So we're now imitating search a customer comments. Trying to do something on this website. Hmm. And hopefully CloudWatch RUM will get us some information coming back.
Absolutely. So I'm going to try to adopt this bunny here. Pay for that one. And something went wrong.
Okay.
There's the customer impacting issue. That's a loss of customer trust. But I've instrumented this web app with CloudWatch RUM. So I'm sending telemetry data to CloudWatch RUM, and we can go see what that looks like.
Okay.
So we're going on over to the CloudWatch console.
Mm-hmm.
And down underneath application monitoring, you now can click on RUM, which is pretty cool. And you have the overview page here, which gives you a quick heads up on how your app is doing. You got indicators around the overall traffic, the performance, and the errors as well. You can see there are indeed errors. And here's a link directly to the errors and sessions tab, which we can jump directly into.
Okay. So this is currently loading the errors coming from RUM, right? From the user perspective.
Okay. The they're coming from the my web app, and I'm just mm-hmm. using the RUM web client to actually send these to the RUM service where I'm doing basically analytics and helping you process that data. So you can do this sort of visualization with that information.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Can you also funnel it into, for instance, CloudWatch Alarms, so that if there is a specific type of error that a downstream process is being triggered?
Yes,
absolutely. Okay.
Yeah, just short answer is, you can have an alarm for the number of errors. So, if you see any increase in the number of errors, you can alarm and get notified.
Okay.
And so we have a timeline of when the errors. This is really helpful for determining when an error actually started being seen, and I can immediately detect that sort of issue, and also undo recent changes that may have been introduced. And I can immediately remediate, reduce my mean time to resolution, or mean time recovery rather. And because I don't really need that to be sitting active in production in order to reproduce these issues, these errors. Mm-hmm.
So that could actually be part of my deployment pipeline that I basically measure whenever I have a new deployment, whenever I ship a new deployable, and if the numbers, if the error rate goes up, I'm actually able to understand that there's a client-side issue.
Yeah.
Okay.
And is it collecting proper JavaScript errors and all that stuff? Because I'm seeing the dashboard, that's wonderful, but is it actually collecting the logs, collecting the error that happens here as well?
Yeah, down here we can see the error in more detail. You can see different types of errors. You can immediately see how many users were impacted. It's very handy for determining user impact. And you can also see when it last occurred, which is super useful as well.
Right.
For knowing that if we've undone the change, we could tell when it was fixed and see that it actually is working better. Right. For the actual error, we're going to drill into one of these. You come on to the error details section. I can see if it's specific to Chrome or a browser or a device. Mm-hmm. In this case, it looks like Chrome Android is being impacted mm-hmm. with this particular issue. I could even see the version of Chrome that was impacted. And down here, let's see. Actually, I don't have it. So.
In this case, is there a limitation when it comes to languages to your front end applications? This is JavaScript, right? So, but let's say we're doing iOS applications or Android. Can we also get the telemetry from those client side applications, or are we purely doing JavaScript in this case?
Yeah, currently we support web applications and React Native mobile apps.
Okay. And is there a chance for Dan to show us how this actually looks in the code? What did you need to add to the code to make this work? Because you mentioned a little snippet, JavaScript snippet, in the header. But is there a way for you, Dan, to show us this snippet so we can kind of see how it looks like?
Yeah, that would be nice because we also had that question in the chat around that, if it uses something like an agent or something like that. So what are the actual moving parts in this?
Yeah, absolutely. And I'll jump right over to that. So here's that stack trace I wanted to show you associated with this error to help you reproduce that issue. So for the code snippet that you need to create, let's see. If you went through the app monitor creation, you'd get presented with a code snippet that you could put into your app. And it would look a lot like this.
Ooh, can you make this a lot bigger?
And when we start with app create app monitor, so they know how they can get the JavaScript snippet.
Okay. I'm back up to the top here. You just add app monitor. This is actually super quick and easy as well. All you need is a name. You do and an application domain, which is your right here. About the HTTPS. And that's really it. That's all the selection I need to do. Everything else I could choose the defaults for. I could choose to send the performance telemetry data or the JavaScript errors or not. I'm allowing cookies in this case so I can see the sessions and user journeys, which we haven't talked about yet. And this is where I can actually send that data also, or my data from my app to CloudWatch logs to do further analysis like we're talking about here with the alarming.
Okay.
And actually just create. Takes a second. That gets me.
There we go. Oh, there's the snippet. It's even minimized, so I wouldn't be able to understand what it does.
Awesome. And you just add this into your just like
piece of code. Okay. Yep, here it's in my layout HTML file.
Okay.
That's the basic one. It's right below. It's in the HTML code in the head section.
Okay. Awesome. And like, is there like a, maybe I missed this, but we talk about it sending telemetry. Is it like there's a fixed amount of telemetry it emits, or is there a way we can do something custom or limited to just only do specific things? How do we control that?
Yeah, so I think by default we give you some standard configurations, and of course there's some flexibility that you know you can select the performance one, HTTP errors, JavaScript errors,
right?
And then in addition, you can also modify the code snippet. There's a little bit more configuration which we have in the user docs that you can do. So this includes, for example, DOM elements, DOM events. If you wanted to capture those, that's also possible.
That's good. I think that's a wonderful thing. And you know, this not only enables you to view this in real time, right? Like on a wonderful dashboard, but as Varsha mentioned before, you can do this end-to-end testing. It's you literally can observe your code working from your infrastructure to actually the end user clients. And it is, as Dennis mentioned in the beginning, it's a wonderful part of your deployment pipeline because you can actually see has a change actually impacted the end users, because let's be honest, a lot of that code runs on a user's browser, and we want to make sure we get that information come back.
Yeah, because traditionally, a lot of our telemetry really is we watch the servers. We have a look at the servers. What's happening here? Do we have any errors? Does something break down? But we don't really see, don't really have insight into the customer experience, and that's a very important part. And the more interactive the client-side applications become using things like React or React Native or other frameworks, JavaScript-based frameworks in the client, we very often don't have any insight into that. And this is where this really can help have the whole, you can trace throughout the whole application, including the customer, who's the most important part of the application.
How fast do these things come back into CloudWatch? Is it actually real time, or what is the delay in this case?
It's very close to real time. It's near real time. We see within minutes the first time you instrument. It's
excellent. And we have a question here from Randall. We all know Randall. Hi, Randall says, let me just move myself on the bottom here so we can get the ASL. Endpoints are regional. Will there be global endpoints for this kind of case? Like if we have an application that's spread across the globe? Or is it currently only regional?
Currently, it is regional. The app monitor resource is a regional resource, so currently it is.
Okay, excellent. Well, thank you. Thank you both Dan and Varsha. Before we let you go, I think the important question here is, how much does this cost?
And when is it available?
Yeah.
Yeah, the pricing is based on the number of events you send to CloudWatch RUM, and it's about $1 for every 100,000 events. More details are on the pricing page.
Awesome.
I just want to also close that, you know, now with CloudWatch RUM, you can do end-to-end monitoring within CloudWatch, from digital experience all the way to infrastructure.
Which is very important. And is it available right now? Can people go and try it out?
Yes, it is. It is available. So you can, please do try it out and let us know.
Cool.
Thank you so much.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Varsha, Dan. Thank you very much for a wonderful demo. If you're all interested in checking out CloudWatch RUM, real user monitoring, is that the thing? Yeah. Real user monitoring. So you can do end-to-end monitoring on CloudWatch. Please do check it out right now. It's available on the CloudWatch dashboard as we speak. So, with that out of the way, let's bring in the very loud transition, and then I think Dennis and I will just talk for a couple of minutes. So we'll be back here.
That's going to be fun.
We'll be back here in a couple of seconds.